machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part. You can't even passively take part. And you've got to put your bodies upon the gears, upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1.
This is your Edge Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
A woman who stunned television viewers in England yesterday by revealing she slept with more than 1,000 men said she used to be one.
What?
Yeah. Used to be a dude. You know, I actually have the video here. I might as well not even... I don't see why I should...
What an interesting story.
I don't see why I would tell it. I would just maybe just play this. It's a fascinating story.
Hi, I'm Crystal Warren. You may know me as the sex mad cougar that slept with over 1,000 men. Well, I'm here today to tell you an even bigger secret about my past. I was born Christopher Alan Snowden, now Crystal Louise Warren. I had to go on hormones, go up to London every 6 to 8 weeks to be analysed by a psychiatrist. And then I was on the hormones for 2 years. And then I had a gender reassignment to have the full sort of operation. So now I am fully female. At the age of 14, that was when I felt that I was attracted to boys, but not as I was then in the body that I was in then, basically. So, and I always knew that I wasn't gay, and in my mind, I always knew that I should have been born as a female. I've slept with a hell of a lot of men, over 1,000 to be precise, and I know there's going to be a hell of a lot of men out there that are probably thinking, oh my God, yeah, she's basically lied to us. These guys that I've slept with know by sleeping with me that I am a woman, and there's nothing about me male at all. I don't feel that I've lied to these men, because at the end of the day, these guys that I sleep with, they haven't said to me, oh, I've got a girlfriend, or I've got a wife, or I've got children. There's some things of people's past that's irrelevant. And to me, actually bringing up my past and what I've been through, to me is irrelevant, because I've come all this way to change my body to how it should have been. And
you used to have a dink. I think that's probably something guys would want to know before they hit it and quit it. Wouldn't you? Would you want to know?
Looking at her, though, I don't think a lot of these 1,000 men really were that would be that particular.
Same thing.
Yeah, I don't know. A lot of people in England, do they have bad taste or something?
I think she might be the hottest chick in England.
Yeah, that's another. She's got pretty good guns, eh? Pretty good gun show.
Yeah,
over there.
Decent hooters, but yeah. terrible teeth. This is a classic line from this. I was reading the story just going, what? Are you kidding me? Someone says this. Now I've had my operation. I've got the body I want. I like to sleep with as many men as I can. I was sleeping with up to 7 men a day, and I can't get more than 24 hours without sex. 3 months after surgery, I went to a swinger party and had sex with 10 different men. And when I was running a snack bar at a golf club, I would lock the door and have sex with the customers I got friendly with. Some of the women golfers didn't like it very much.
You think?
I would want to know, wouldn't you? There's the big discussion. If you were having sex with a really hot chick and then she says, oh, you want to look at my family photo album from when I was 0 to 19? And there she is, like, with a football shirt on or at prom with a girl with a beard. Hello. Would you not be upset?
I think so. I'd be upset, A, going, 1,000. I wonder where I am on that number. Okay, first. And then you're like, oh, no. Really? I bet you she likes it in the...
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I don't think there's a place she won't take it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just weird. I couldn't do it. Even if she looked like Alessandra Ambrosio, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah. But if you didn't know?
Yeah, I guess so.
If so, doesn't matter. You wouldn't do Alexander Ambrosio if he had a little dink?
Yeah, I would.
Just to say no to.
Okay, I would.
Those are your Edge Files, whatever the hell day it is in February of the year 2012.
The Edge Files on 102.1. The Edge.
An important message.
The Dean Blundell Show. Weekday mornings on The Edge.
There's a gay frat house, the first of its kind, I think, in Canada. It's in Montreal at McGill, is that what you said?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The brothers of...
And then they bite my tongue.
That's good.
Just read it.
And then they bite my tongue.
Just read it.
Like any other frat boys, the brothers of Delta Lambda Phi might be expecting to drink beer or party it up on occasion. But that other frat fundamental of chasing girls, not so much, it says.
Hmm.
You know, this is a picture of all of them in front of their frat house. They couldn't look gayer. That is the loser gay frat house, too, by the way. Not because they're gay, but because if you see the picture of them on the front page, you're not sure if they're gay computer analysts or if they're gay mathematicians. Either way, they're having a great time.
I'm sure they're very nice people.
Yeah. Look at them.
They look very nice.
They're biting your tongue. Are you biting your tongue?
Yeah, but although, you know what I think? The funny thing is, they say this is the first for Canadian universities.
Surprise.
I beg to differ. I think it's the first that's actually come out of the closet.
Because
these guys are just the ones who have the courage to admit they're gay in terms of a frat house.
Dude, how many hazing incidents in regular frat house, just ones where they don't care if you're gay or straight, usually straight ones, how many of the hazing incidents involved anuses and mouths?
Honestly. And the way they all run around and live together.
Yeah.
And
yeah, all of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was all gay anyway.
Yeah, these guys are just, they're actually cooler.
Yeah. They're like, hey, we know it's gay. Yeah. We're embracing it.
Exactly.
Okay, fellas, what I want you to do is, this is a totally straight hazing. I want you to stick this marshmallow in your ass cheeks, carry it across the room, and deposit it in that guy's mouth.
But can you imagine the hazing for the gay fraternity?
Is this a gay frat? No, straight, totally straight. Do it. Oh, well, I'm over here whacking it.
Oh, yeah, get that marshmallow in there. Get that. Oh, yeah.
Maybe the gay fraternity actually for the hazing. They have to go like fold women's underwear or something.
Yeah, they go build a picnic table with their bare hands.
Yeah.
Okay, fellas, what you got to do is take out the garbage.
Grow a beard.
No. Okay, no. We're going to take apart this car engine. You have to put it all back together again.
Okay, fellas, you got to watch like 5 hours of Man Tracker straight. Think you can do it? And it's not what it sounds like. It's not what it sounds like, fellas.
I think it's great. Good for them.
Oh,
gay it up. Imagine how much fun they have with those doors closed.
Imagine how neat their frat house is.
Imagine how good the food is in that.
Oh, yeah. Everything.
Great
man, I want to join.
Toronto's New Rock. In the Dean Blundell Show. Weekday mornings, 102.1. The Edge.
Time for some listener email. If you sent us one, thank you. Hey, guys. Driving in and some other names we came up with for the gay frat house. This is from Lucas. Because we were talking about in Montreal at McGill, they have their first, they said, gay frat house. But someone emailed me and said that they've actually had a gay frat house here for over 100 years. They're called the Montreal Canadiens.
Oh, top draw.
That's from Mark. Thank you, Mark. Yes. Anyway, Lucas says, driving in some other gay names for the gay frat house. Because they got, you know, the Sigma Pi, Delta, Wi-Fi. Where's that guy? Stuff that ends in I. Beta Sigma Mud Pie?
Yeah.
Delta Brown Eye? I gotta tell you, I think it's great.
I'd prefer to be in it.
Yeah, me too.
I hate jocks. I hate the typical. I hate the average sort of frat house the way it's always been.
When I was at university, there was these guys next to us, and they were part of a frat. And they had these crazy towels they put on the door to denote what was going on inside.
Mm.
And I can guarantee you, because I knew them, nothing was going on in there. It was just a big ruse.
It's just a bunch of dudes telling stories to top one another while the football game's on, and they're really staring at their buddy's ass while nachos are being made. Like,
and you know they're probably having gay sex anyway, too. So at least these guys jumped the shark and said, forget it. We're gay. We know we're gay. Those guys just don't know they're gay yet.
I bet you they'll have a lot of cute chicks at their cute women at their house, too.
Yeah.
It's like a
hot
safe
babes.
House.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, that's the best
it's
thing.
It's the only frat party you go to and chicks don't get assaulted. I think it's a great idea.
It is a great idea.
Man, you're right, too. That place will be so clean.
Clean. And
their dinners will be good.
Amazing.
Their homework will be done.
They wine tasting.
Be in shape.
No, dude, you got to see a picture of these guys.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Looking
well, but, yeah, this is like the before picture because they just started it, right?
So so they're in front of their frat house. There's some guy on the hard right in the picture. He is such a dork. Even the gay, like nobody wanted him in a frat house. I think the gay people are just so nice, they took the guy. You know what I mean?
Yeah. They're so nice.
They're so nice. They're the nicest frat guys, too. They do community service. They have parties. They do everything other frat houses do, they said.
But the funny thing would be the hazing, because like we were saying earlier, they'd have to do seemingly straight tasks. Because we all know that
overtly straight.
Because the other frat boys do all seemingly gay tasks.
They do, dude. You know how many frat like they do these ones where you play pickup sticks with your butt cheeks. It's everything something to do with the butt. Yeah. They rest their testicles on each other's faces. It's just the stupidest thing.
Well, we've all heard the plunger stories.
Yeah, absolutely. Haven't you, Derek?
No. Actually, I haven't.
Tell him.
Well, that's where part of the hazing and to get in the frat is where they
see how much of the plunger you can take.
Yeah, it's like take. Oh, yeah, it's like they test. Like,
that end.
Yeah, they're checking your oil.
Oh, it's a dipstick. Yeah.
They're checking your oil, but sometimes you draw mud.
Oh, yeah. They're checking your mud. Yeah.
Well, yeah,
those are what happen in straight frat houses.
Yeah,
so this gay frat house, they do like woodworking. They go, okay, fellas, come on over here. Now we're gonna do your next hazing routine for the rookies: changing oil of this car, and it's a domestic.
Oh. And after that, it's time to chop wood.
And it's actually just chopping wood. I know it sounds like it'd be fun, but it isn't. So I just get an axe and chop some wood. Should do that more often.
Chop wood?
Yeah, it's great exercise. Yeah. It could be. But yeah, I don't understand why the... I think it's great. Good for them.
You know what I wish, though?
That you don't drop your keys in front of the frat house?
No, but that too. But
that you don't fall asleep there with really loose-fitting pants?
No, I was thinking of a sorority. A gay sorority. That'd be so cool.
Yeah. You gotta think that's already going on.
I wonder if there is.
I don't know. I don't care.
Dude, how many stories in What Happened include, so I was in college... And, like, this girl and I were, like, just having a glass of wine after we were studying. And
it's true, actually.
Mm-hmm. So every sorority's gay.
Yeah.
Or there's some gay in it. And that's beautiful to me.
I'm surprised that Toronto wasn't the first. Like, the U of T wasn't the first or one of the ones.
There's no gay
here.
People here. It's like Iran.
What?
We don't have gay people in our province.
We don't have gay people in province. Yeah, we sent them to Montreal to start a frat house. There's only four of them, and five maybe.
Right. It's because the drinking age is younger.
Oh,
18.
Oh, that's so wrong. Less pain. No.
I need it to numb it. After the hazing, things get wicked. Just go there, get some vodka, pour it right on it. Numb the pain. Let's watch it taste out of your mouth.
I think those straight fraternities do that, though. Like, they do the...
Dude,
the,
every hazing the bottle, thing they do is
like,
gay.
The drinking up that.
They do the butt... Yeah, the butt chug. Yeah. It's called the butt chug.
It's crazy. Like,
I don't know why.
I know.
Every, you think about it now. every fraternity's gay. So does it really matter? At least the gay guys know what they don't do the hazing thing. Yeah, because they're like, whatever, dude. We've been doing that for years.
Yeah.
Oh, that old thing. With the tube and the funnel. Oh, you guys are amateur. You guys really want to take this to the next level? Turpentine. That's all I'm saying. Boom.
I'm surprised, actually.
Or cheese whiz. Yeah. You want to get this thing going? Spackle some cheese whiz up there. And then get your partner to scream Armageddon. Now that is fun. Maybe hazing includes, like, they get, like... They actually get a real girl in there.
That's what I was thinking, too.
And they put her on a table and get...
I don't
and they
want...
Go, and then, like, the gay frat house leader goes, "Okay, rookies, eat it. Do it. No?
No.
Touch it. Look at it.
You don't know.
I bet.
Because
I want to talk. Can we get a hold of these guys? Is there any way we can get a hold of these guys this
I'll
morning?
Try.
I would love to talk to these guys. I think they're awesome.
Yeah, let's find them. Because you're right. Because it's the straight hazing, which everyone knows you have to do and you have to pass in order to get in the frat house.
Which is stupid.
Involves stuff like you said earlier, eating the marshmallow that came from...
The butt cheeks.
Yeah. So yes, why wouldn't they have similar tasks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Eat the hot dog that came from them.
Yeah. Just yank it out.
Who knows?
Yeah.
We're just trying to do comparatives here in a very serious note.
Okay, guys, you got to sit down here and watch Speed Vision all day.
Oh, that's tough.
And some of them, I bet you, during those hazings, they probably break.
You go, all right, I like it.
Get out. You're separating that's how the wheat from the chaff.
Yeah. The wheat from the chaff. Yeah, I wonder, hey, that's like their biggest nightmare. They start in with a girl and they go, oh, I actually enjoy this.
Yeah, I could get...
Forget it. I'm out. I'm going to Delta Sigma Wiener.
Or the other guy, like the one who's really gay during those tasks. He's like, I'm going to try out for the straight frat house.
Seriously? They have way more fun. Yeah.
This is the Dean Blundell Show.
We are dickhead free.
102.1 The Edge.
Your week in review coming up in a minute. How is it, by the way? What's a word to describe today's week in review, T-Bone? What the? Almost said the F word. What the F?
You would too if your name was
Huuaaugh. Oh, this is where we're going to feature the guy that called in and messed up Helen Keller and Harry Carey.
How do you do that? Harry Carey was a drunken, legendary baseball announcer for the Chicago Cubs. Helen Keller was a deaf-blind mute that overcame tremendous odds as a young girl in the 1800s. I think that's when she lived. I don't know. I remember I had these books about perseverance when I was a kid, and she was in it.
But did she like hot dogs? I don't know. No one could tell.
Toronto's New Rock. In the Dean Blundell Show. Weekday mornings, 102.1 The Edge.
And now, the Dean Blundell Show presents The Week in Review. Yeah. It's true. Week in Review.
You know... Today we've been talking about this gay frat house in Montreal at McGill University, and while I hate separation of sex, race, religion, or sexual orientation, what I do like is the fact that people stick up for themselves and are proud of themselves. It's hard to be proud of yourselves these days, especially when you're...
Us.
So when you see people going out on a limb, sitting in front of a newspaper camera guy, photographer, that's what I meant,
willing to take their picture and show it in newspapers around the world, saying, yes, we're gay, and this is our frat house. I think to myself, what was I saying?
What? Are you talking?
Oh. Here's your week in review. Listener discretion is advised.
Mm-hmm.
Mother effers.
You know what I'm doing right now, Dean?
What?
I'm biting my tongue.
Run a train on that place. Yeah. Maybe just one big rip. A lot of words that rhyme with sucker.
I made it a little plasticky. You want this?
You
want
to get on top of this?
Come on, take this.
Want to jump on top of this action? Thinking of getting my tubes tied.
Suck.
Bing, bazoom. You're good.
I don't even know what that means.
That Swedish guy can give a mean... Wait.
What are you shoving? I'm not putting that there.
I'm twisting and pulling, and they're clamping down, too.
He knows very little about foreplay.
Chamber of secretions.
Out of here. Is that a dirty one?
No. I'm going to shut your mouth.
Not the three musketeers.
It's effing creepy.
Harry Potter's Harry Pooter.
How's the butt?
How's the butt?
Was your bag open enough for maybe a testicle to fall out?
Man, I missed that on so much action.
Butt chugging?
Bringing in some asses.
Some ass models.
We're going to have a ghost gangbang.
What?
If you squeeze real hard, you might get three kids.
He is a bona fide...
The orderly is giving you blood or poop.
Blood or poop.
Or semen.
Me dancing with the heavy objects.
Get naked, fellas. A friend of mine put his hand in the glove, and his hand was way bigger than mine. That glove was wrecked for the rest. I had to get new gloves.
Yeah. He never went back.
Upside down old people in jumpsuits playing shuffleboard. Does your place smell like piss? Everybody was soccer fighting.
A.K.A. the pullout.
And he's done some damage in other areas. F it pisses me off. Girl at a bar being a C.
You can squeeze a couple kids out of this.
Bust it, and then you have a shower.
Yeah, the ghost of that white stuff too, baby.
You must put your pecker back in your pants.
Little guy. little testes.
Look, you little nuts.
You little rat nuts.
Yeah, dude, rats have nuts. Insert here. The next time you get your pickle sticky.
So after your past year, say, aw.
A couple of blasts of ultrasound to the testes.
You know what you need to do is wear ladies' underwear when you do it, sir.
Oh, ooh, yay, ace, tay, oh, say, it, gay. It's like the reverse donkey punch to your testes. Because you're talking about rubbing one out.
People live on the moon and they pull down the pants where they say, hey, I earthed you.
We're squeezing real hard.
Kill them all.
Sir, do you have to fondle my nuts like that?
Yeah, it's like the taint.
An honor prison raping.
Get it right on the nut. Get it right on the little nut.
Pretty much guarantee that dude I saw gain a lot of weight is not pregnant.
Agreed to lick his own chest for his girlfriend while they were having action. I don't want to say because I'm going to bite my tongue. Proctology model.
It's lemonade.
Yeah. Sexually assaulting a man with pliers and giving him urine to drink.
That's sick SOB.
Chimpanzee ate to me more.
Oh, they're going back in time, bro.
Way to go, tardy.
With the caramel, you tied the caramel, bro? Grabbed the cat by the back of the head, grabbed a hammer off the microwave, and whack, whack, whack.
I'm only into horses, not donkeys.
Dumber for half a foot long.
Pervs like you.
Well, listen, good luck to you. I hope you get some really young stuff in you.
Come down here and run into my car.
Talking as you're spanking it.
You don't want to talk about your teeth?
And lube up in the bedroom.
Bump into a lot of douchebags.
What are you, tardy?
Missed your alarm, tardy?
She's one of them racist bitches.
Oh, completely.
Maybe he's got a big hog.
I think he might have a big hog.
You playing with my dinghy?
Oh, dude, yeah. He's going to get it.
He could F a nun. I couldn't give an S. He can give me his money and give it to whoever he wants. We're divorced. The man's dead.
Yeah, take off your pants.
It's your first splooge sock.
Because I'm douching to the east. Douching to the west. Hey, how's it going? It's a girl. How's it going?
Yeah, I'm calling in about the semen demon.
I'm calling in about that semen demon.
I'm calling in about that semen demon you guys are talking about.
No, it's Harry Carey.
No, that's Harry Carey.
Not Helen exactly. Keller. Spunk junkie pie guy. It says semen demon on it.
Oh!
Yeah, semen demon. Big, that's right across the back of the butt.
Let's not soup. Her dog was blind, too. My favorite planet's the sun.
That's a little bit of a red flag.
Maybe she likes sailors because there are drips coming from the E.
No.
They're telling a girl to get down here.
She wipes her ass with sandpaper. Pick up the hot dog.
He's telling a girl to open her mouth.
Yes. Who put this plunger in the toilet? Who's been sipping on my braille books with golf shoes?
Your tongue. I believe he sings to your tongue.
Oh, yeah.
We'll move the furniture. She was bobbing for French fries.
Sucks to be her.
No.
Especially if you've seen the video.
No.
You would too if your name was.
Would you put a bumper sticker on a Ferrari?
That's what I'd reply. No, but I would on a beat up Hyundai.
So where's the tat?
Yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show.
It's going to scar me for life, and it's going to haunt me forever. Even at an old age.
102.1.
I don't know how you put up with it.
The Edge.
More about the gay frat house. Coming up in a few minutes. We'll chat about that. It's you know, it's interesting because have you read the story about the gay fraternity?
I'm too busy staring at the pictures.
Are you on their Facebook site?
I went on the Facebook site. Well, that's because we tried to message them, too.
Yeah. They said they get a lot of complaints.
They do?
Yeah,
really?
So. Yeah.
Who would complain in this day and age?
I don't know. So I'll just read this to you. Well, some might have thought that would sufficiently encompass transgendered individuals who consider themselves male. McGill's main lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender group. Queer McGill wasn't happy when it saw the frat's literature. Queer McGill.
Sounds like somebody's nickname.
Hey, who's that?
Oh, it's Queer McGill again.
Queer. It's like Jugs McGee.
Yeah.
Queer McGill.
Queer McGillicuddy.
Queer McGill thought the language separating males and those who identify as male implied the transgendered individuals are somehow not real men. They were just pretending to be men, explained Queer McGill administrator Elise Lewis. She says, quote, "There's a lot of misunderstanding with this whole thing. People from DLP don't know there's a problem with language.
DP?
They saw it as an attack." This starts a whole thing now, right? Because everybody separates themselves. So.
Yeah. It's fracturing them.
Yeah. That's what, that's their fight. That's their fight. It'll be slappy and pinchy for sure, but that's their fight.
Can't they all just get along?
I don't know. Oh, imagine how, like if one guy pisses another guy off in that house.
Ooh.
Imagine that cat fight in the backyard.
Be hot.
Really?
720. Yeah, I think it's great. Gay it up. What?
No, we're just laughing, I think, because of how, I don't know, all those other hazings are in all the other frat houses.
Yeah. Those are, you want to talk about a negative stereotype. Every, if you've gone to university, you know every initiation to every frat house can't get more homoerotic. It can't. So I would like to, if we can track these guys down or someone from their frat house, I would like to find out what they do for initiation.
Mm-hmm. Well, they may never tell because that's one of the big hush-hush secrets of fraternities.
Do they, like we said, maybe change the oil on a car, look at nudie magazines.
Just try and score with a lady.
Get over here, you guys. This is a piece de resistance. You have to open mouth kiss this girl.
Oh! Oh! Ew!
Christ, no.
And do it while watching a war movie.
Ah! No, stop that.
And you have to wear sweatpants the whole time.
Oh! Ah!
You gotta watch the Super Bowl this Sunday.
Yeah.
Not for the commercials.
And you have to address everybody as pal.
Oh.
Or chief.
Chew tobacco.
Hey, Edge, how are you?
I'm pretty good.
Were you part of a sorority in university, or did you go to university?
I did go to university. I went to Western. They have like a big sorority scene there, but no, I was not. I knew people in sororities, though.
Yeah, the whole thing's stupid.
I don't understand.
I don't care
it.
If it's straight, gay, brown, white.
You're paying to have friends.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I just
you pay to have people back you up in case there's a bar fight. That's really all it
is. Exactly. But they can't. Half the sorority people could never fight anyway, so.
Why?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did you hear of any late night activities in sorority?
Oh, yeah. There was a rule when you went to a fraternity house, you had to be out of the house. If you went to like a party, you had to be out of there by 2 a.m.
Why?
Stuff could happen to you after that time.
Oh, there's no.
No,
guarantee.
I meant like in a sorority.
Yeah,
like,
a sorority.
Would you ever show up and like? Because basically, it's like having a never-ending supply of beer.
Yes.
If you're in a sorority and you got a bunch of babes around and you're all like-minded and you feel a little frisky, it's like a never-ending glass.
Well,
of
I know
poontang.
One like during like hazing, what they would do to girls.
What would they do?
Like one sorority, they like, would make them basically smear like.
Oh.
Stuff that comes out of your, you know what, on their face, yeah.
The backside or the front?
The back.
What?
No!
Yeah.
Women would do that? Get
yes.
out of here. How does that make them leading members of society?
I don't know.
Well, because when they're done that, Derek, they go help bag groceries down at the thrifty.
Oh. I just hope they wash their hands.
Okay. Then they go serve people soup with poop face down at the soup kitchen.
It's to break you down and reunite you or something?
Break you down. Put poop on your face to break you down and bring you together?
Yes. All together and has one.
Yeah, that makes sense.
We've all had the poop
How about a team chant? How about a team chant instead
Isn't that
of a
good
poop
enough?
Face?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Once that would come out, I'd be out. I don't understand why you'd want to be a part of that.
Hmm. Hey, by the way, speaking of which, have you had any tea today?
Have I had any tea?
Mm-hmm.
I did have some tea. All roads lead to here, don't they?
Would you, while we haven't done this in a while, would you care to share with us your talents? That if people, you know, listening for the first time, would you care to share the talent with us?
Sure, sure, I can.
Thanks. Here we go.
I just pictured everybody in that office where she is.
What she's is in a she cubicle. Doing? You can't see.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay. That picture is talking right
into the mic. It's kind of weird because I get up.
It was a cubicle.
Around, so, you know.
Yeah, I know.
It's kind of odd.
It was a cubicle. Now it's a pubicle.
It is a pubicle.
I made a funny joke about that because you farted in the microphone.
And it wasn't loud enough. You didn't get in our sorority.
Yeah. You're out.
102.1 The Edge. Pauses. Okay. That's enough.
This pause brought to you by the Dean Blundell Show.
Weekday mornings on the Edge.
Time for Wha Happened Ladies Day today, though. No dudes. Hi, the Edge. No. Hi, the Edge.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
It's Brian Henry.
Oh, no way.
No way.
No.
Wow. All right.
Hey, what happened?
What happened?
What is it you can't face?
Well, it's not really what happened to me. It's what my mom's boyfriend says is wrong with me.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah. Your mom's boyfriend. How old are you?
I'm 23.
How old's your mom's boyfriend?
50.
How old's your mom?
She's 40.
Okay. She had you at 17. Oh, dude.
Wow.
Getting a little creeped out, though, here. Anyway.
You know.
She's a very pretty lady. Don't worry.
Is she really?
I meant more about what he's about to say to you.
Yeah.
What's Go ahead.
Well, no, he just says that my email off. It got mail off. My email off.
You got what?
My ear melt off.
Your ear melt off?
Kind of like Down syndrome.
Hold it. What are you talking
are you
about,
doing?
Ma'am?
Does he have Down syndrome?
No. He thinks that my email off. Like I'm a few screws short.
Oh, he thinks you're way off.
Yeah, I'm a...
I got to tell you, I think he's onto something. I got to tell you.
That's right.
Yeah.
That was like the most random.
Yeah, I know. Like, what
That's
is
right.
That
mean?
Where did that come from? That might be a catchphrase in your household, but not mine.
Yeah.
Well, use it from now on. Your email's off.
Oh, no.
Your email's off?
That's
your
what I keep hearing.
Your ear?
Off.
Melts off?
Yeah, your email off.
Why is this funny?
Hilarious.
I don't even get it.
What's wrong with you, ma'am? Do you have a job?
Yes, actually, I do.
What do you do?
I'm a decorator.
What do you decorate?
Home.
Christmas tree?
Oh, yeah.
An interior decorator.
Are you really?
Oh, okay.
Yes,
wow.
I am.
I
Everyone's an interior decorator.
Yeah. If you move a chair from one wall to another.
I honestly hate that profession, I swear to God. I mean, I've done a good job in my house. I'm like, if I just chose to help other people, I'm an interior decorator.
Yeah, dude.
I did it too.
I picked the colors for my new house. Just moved. Well, I didn't. A friend of mine did. But yeah, I'm a decorator.
Yeah, no, you bought beds. You're an interior decorator.
Well, I didn't actually.
No, oh, so you're not actually.
No, wait. Wait a second.
You're a broker.
I told them where to put the stuff. So guess what?
Yeah.
Decorator.
There you go.
At the Edge.
Hi.
Hi.
Am I on?
Yeah. Who's this?
Let's hope.
Alana.
Alana?
Yes.
I like that name, Alana.
Me too.
Hey, what happened?
What happened? Okay, so this is pretty embarrassing. Me and my boyfriend were getting frisky maybe like a year ago. And he was going to give me some face loving, I guess. And
real chow. We call that real chow.
Okay, he was going to give me real chow.
Yeah.
And he got behind me because I like that more, I guess. And
That's it. You know, I have never done that.
Really?
Never? From the...
upside down.
Like from the bumper.
Better.
Real chow from the bumper.
Never?
Never.
It's my favorite.
Does it really?
It does.
Why?
Well, I guess I can't,
because it involves the other part, too, a little bit.
Oh, no. But
no, it's where your nose lands.
That's what I'm saying. Sometimes your nose gets...
Nobody feels right up.
Let's do it. Okay. How do you do it? Right in the microphone. In the microphone.
You gotta open
it. I mean, for your nose and you're going for it.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah.
I got it.
You just gotta...
I get it. The tongue's at the top, which is really at the bottom. Your nose is in the middle.
you just gotta be very careful of your breathing. Yeah.
Go ahead. Yeah, you're still on.
Yeah. So, anyways, I was getting pretty close to the
to full enjoyment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I started to, I ended up letting one rip in his face.
Wow.
Yeah.
Dark
it
and
was
smelly.
Pretty bad. It wasn't that bad, but
dark and smelly.
It was really embarrassing. We stopped after that.
He stopped after that.
She says we stopped.
He stopped.
Blacked out.
More browned out by the Edge.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
Heather.
Hi, Heather. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Hey, what happened?
what happened was, when I was about 18, I was... up early in the morning with my boyfriend, and I went out. I had a shower. I was just in the towel. Went outside for a smoke, and saw my neighbor's dog running across the street. So of course, being a good neighbor, go running out to go get the dog, grab her, bend down to pick her up. And when I stood up, my towel didn't come with me. So I was 18 and standing butt naked in the middle of my street. Turned around just in time to see my neighbor come running up to get his dog. And
I bet.
Have you seen my dog around here? I thought he was really close to you. I saw him. I could have sworn I saw him next to your nipples. No, that's not him.
So butt naked on my street. Yeah.
Right. Are you hot?
Haven't had any complaints in that department.
I love when they just come out and say it. Never had any complaints.
Hot. Yeah. Super hot. Hi, The Edge.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. You should just swear off the caffeine and go with Postum.
Okay.
Where are you calling from?
Mississauga.
And what's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa, you sound very cute. You sound like you're about 3'6".
Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Okay, so
Hey, what happened?
I'm in Cuba vacationing with my friends, and as you know, the food in Cuba is just miserable. So anyway, we decided to go, we ate some food, and we decided to go sunbathe on the beach. So I'm laying out on the beach, and, the food is not agreeing with me. So I figure I'll just, let out a fart, no big deal. So I let out a fart, and I thought that it was just a fart. And when I got up, I was sitting in the sand, so there was, a bunch of sand, kind of stuck to my butt.
Oh,
and I went to the water, and,
started dripping down. Oh, it was so embarrassing. It was like the worst thing of my life.
You drew mud, did you? Did you draw mud?
Yes, I drew mud.
Did you roll into the ocean? That's what I would have done.
You're like laughing. I just ran. I was so embarrassed.
Yeah. You win. Congratulations to your little thing, you. You little thing, you. This little cute girl on the beach and she drew mud.
You weren't wearing a thong, were you?
No, but it was a bikini. It was tight.
What color was it?
Did you have a lump in the back, too? Like, you know, when kids poop their diaper? Did you have a little thing in the back?
No, it was just runny.
The Dean Blundell Show. It's their cheery disposition that gives them that warm glow. Weekday mornings on 102.1 The Edge.
We were just talking about how it'd be awesome if you could just walk around saying anything you want with no filter at all.
Yeah, my friend had a major head injury at one point in his life, and
did he fall off a motorcycle?
This is already funny.
Got into a big snowmobile accident.
Oh, same thing.
Yeah. And but he would just say whatever he wanted, and it was embarrassing, but you could go, he had a head injury.
Are you serious? I want one. What was his, what would he say?
Oh, like about women that he thought were hot. He wouldn't.
Would he say it in front of him?
Yeah.
Well, what would he say to him? Like, give me an example, but don't, you know, swear or anything.
Just talk about her breasts and stuff like that, but he wouldn't say breasts.
Oh, he'd say
dead ass.
Maybe I did have a brain injury.
So give me an example. Let's pretend I'm a girl and you're your brain injured friend with no. All right.
Okay.
How's it going?
Look at her tits. Do you want to have sex with me?
Really?
Yeah, no.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, it sounds great.
I will. You'd be good to do that in, like, when you're on the phone with telemarketers.
Or, like, in line with old people.
God, you smell like death. Yeah.
You better hope this thing speeds up or you might not make it.
Should have gone to the express lane, you old bat.
I'm horny.
Your hooters are low, but I like them.
Love the no teeth thing.
Boy, I'd like to put my P in your M because you have no teeth.
Oh, man.
The Dean Blundell Show, taking a moral stand on morality. Mornings on the Edge.
Hi, Chi.
Hi, dude.
Hi, Chi.
How come you guys so chill out this morning?
Yeah, it's Friday, man.
Your sunglasses on, you're just chilling, you're leaning back, looking at your computer screen.
I understand the word you just said.
You're also chilling.
We're chilling.
Maybe it's Friday, not so late, not so on Friday.
You never been on Friday?
I have, but not in a while. So it's the Friday vibe, you know what I'm saying? Smoking a doobie. Let's spark one up.
Let's spark one up, is that what you said?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's up, dude?
You know what's up?
No, I don't. That's why I asked.
One moment.
Take your gum out? Thanks.
Okay. Dean.
Why are you yelling?
Sorry to disrupt your zen.
Sorry to disrupt our zen?
Your chi, your yin yang. You're on the fence.
Hey, enough of the yin yang.
So, Dean.
Yeah.
I'm so sick. You know all those YouTube videos?
Yeah.
You're so sick of those YouTube videos. Which ones?
No, you know the something girls say, the something guys say, the something Chewbacca say, or the something single girl say to guy, or single white guy say to bang guy, or something Asian guy say. But you must substitute the word something with the word.
The S word.
You know what I say?
What?
I say that is all bull.
Why?
Don't you know? I'm the originator. They all steal my bit from many years ago.
They're stealing it?
What?
What? What happened?
I started calling it. You know what that is?
What?
Jesus!
What is it again?
Did you hear it? Jesus!
bleep she says?
I started it! Wait, one more time! Jesus!
Sounds like you're saying cheesies.
That's what
and
I said.
And they're terrible, so he's saying S-cheesies.
Let me hear it again.
Jesus!
Those are some bad cheesies, I guess.
Let me hear it again. Jesus! Jesus! Jesus!
All right. Okay.
It doesn't matter what it sounds like I sing. It matters that I started it.
Okay, yeah, okay. What do you got?
Oh, you know.
What are you,
why you all laughing? Yeah. I'm serious. I tried to make a point. I started this. I originated number one. Numero uno. You silly white people. I started it with stuff like this.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah. You're very...
You white people. It's so crazy.
Yeah.
That's number one.
What is that?
Get this. Go back to your own country.
Yeah, I remember that one.
Wax on. Wax off. Hey, Dean.
Yeah.
I'm on a boat. Jamaican. You're a Jamaican.
Jamaican?
Oh, yeah. Pacific Mall. Oh, do you remember this one? Two stick so basic.
Two stick so basic.
For the chopsticks.
For the chopsticks.
Yeah, it's a rule.
You know, white people having trouble learning how to use chopsticks? But it's two stick. It's so basic.
Okay.
Anyway, you know how much bitches cost?
What?
What? How much? Winning!
That's Charlie Sheen, dude.
Oh.
Pacific Mall! Hi! Read the fortune cookie! Ba 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 ba! Dot dot dot! In bed!
That was yours?
Of course!
Oh.
Hi! Hey, Dean! Hey, Dean!
Yeah?
Guess what I'm doing?
What?
Fast motion Tai Chi!
I don't even know what he said.
Fast motion.
What? Again, what? Again. Okay.
He's doing Tai
you
Chi.
You can explain to people.
He's doing Tai Chi fast motion.
Oh, fast motion. Looks like he's getting groceries.
It's fast motion Tai Chi.
You're messed up.
Okay, guess what?
What?
I'll be back.
That was yours?
Of course that's mine.
Schwarzenegger, dude.
I sell it for $1 million. Ho, 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 let's go to the cottage. I saw stock, man. Yeah, I saw stock. Oh, how about this one? Hey, let's go to China or Japan or Korea because I can't get any girl here. Guess who said that?
You?
It's a white person. I can't get any girl here, so let's fly on a plane and maybe teach English and maybe Asian girl all over me. All I have to do is step off the plane and I win. Winning! Thank you! Hey, guess what? Buy my book!
Buy my book. That's yours.
Do you like mice?
Yep.
I do. Oh! Have you been to the Pacific Rim? Oh!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hey. Do you have any Asian in you? Want some? Oh! I give it's a good deal, you know. I give you good bargain. Sauce. Remember sauce?
Oh,
sauce.
Yeah, all about
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Yeah. It's severe Asian wetness syndrome.
Oh.
After you knock a couple back,
yeah.
Sometimes Asian gets sauce. Severe Asian wetness syndrome.
I get it. Yeah.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
White man.
White man who?
Who cares? We come to take your land!
Oh,
Guess what?
What?
What foot is so fat? He got baptized in Marineland. We have sweatshop, you have sauna. It's my first erection. So crazy! Say hello to my little friend. Come on, Matt. Don't trust all Asian who smile. Jackie, all based on excellent midnight business model from PacificMall.com. Hey, Todd, what do you call girls who wear short skirt?
What?
Turtle skirt.
Why?
Because it's just enough to cover the snapper.
Achievement, Jay!
Jesus!
The Dean Blundell Show.
I have some bad things to say about those people. Friggin', I heard it. Flying through my friggin' damn wall.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Boom, mama.
102.1.
Friggin', I knew it.
The Edge.
Hey. On the Dean Blundell Show.
Come on.
Head psychic Nikki. On the Dean Blundell Show.
It's the queen, y'all.
Head psychic Nikki.
Do that thing.
And now for the letdown.
Oh, thanks a lot, Dean. Thank
Dude, that's grown on me, too, that intro.
It is?
Yeah, it's grown on me.
Yeah, like a fungus.
Do you think it'll win a Juno?
No.
Oh, too bad.
What is your obsession with Junos? It's like, you know what that's like? It's like winning a 10th place award at a track meet.
Okay, I'll change that to Grammy.
Yeah.
Genie.
Do you really still believe you're going to win a Juno or a Grammy?
Absolutely. No doubt in my mind. Absolutely.
Well, I guess you can go now.
There was all your credibility for everything else.
For what?
Well, I see an Oscar for acting. I see a Juno and a Grammy.
For you?
Yes, absolutely.
But I thought you said you couldn't see where you were. You couldn't see your own thing.
No,
you couldn't
hope. That's a hope.
Other people have seen it.
But you still think you're going to get an Oscar?
We're going to get a lifetime achievement Oscar for all your bit again? Roles?
Well, that could be. I could be like Lauren Bacall or something. No,
Lauren
no,
Bacall. Just like her.
No,
Bacall.
No, no. No, she's going to
Lauren Bacall.
No. I honestly see it.
What did you say?
I'm going to be walking except down uglier. The red rug.
What?
Except uglier.
Lauren Bacall.
What did you say?
Dude, have you seen Lauren Bacall?
Dude, she's beautiful.
She is not... Are you on drugs?
Yeah,
she's disgusting.
One of the hottest women ever, though, still.
50 years ago.
Oh, still, man.
Oh, okay. Go check her out. You can
she's
have her.
She's the one with the gap in her teeth, right?
No, wrong. Lauren Bacall. Look her up.
That's
go
Lauren
ahead.
Hutton.
Tap
oh, that's
it.
Who I was thinking
stupid
of.
Stupid idiot.
Lauren Hutton. Hey, easy. So I don't know my old silver foxes.
Well, if you're gonna start talking about this stuff, you should know, right?
I thought I knew. That was the whole point.
You don't.
Well, obviously not. You've corrected me. And she's still gorgeous.
Lauren Bacall?
Yeah, dude.
Let's see.
You wouldn't have this?
You're an idiot.
She's no Barbara Bush.
You're an idiot.
I take that back.
Yeah.
I'm going to be Nikki Parton.
What? No. Okay, sure. You're Nikki Parton.
84.
Yeah, I know she's 84.
Oh, in 96.
Oh, no. Okay. Do we have something to share with Nikki?
Yeah, we do. Ooh. We recently did some research as to people's favorite guests and features, and there's like 6,000 people did the research online. And
we should do a drum roll. Guess what's number one?
Guess what's number one? Guess what people love the most about this show in this research? Guess what they love the most?
Derek?
Wait.
No.
Research?
Guess.
Todd?
Guess.
No.
Dean?
Guess.
Sean?
Guess.
Psychic Nikki?
The Edgefiles.
Oh. Thanks. You are bad.
Well, guess what was number two?
Okay, guess what number two? Yeah. Number two, drum roll.
Okay,
drum
okay. Oh, boy, I don't want to hear this. I'm going to be last.
Guess.
Dean.
Nope.
Listener email. Open phones. Todd. Me?
Derek's blind.
Okay.
Okay, but guess what number three was? It was...
Dean, Todd, Sean, Derek.
Come on.
Nikki.
Todd on the street.
Oh, good.
Bad.
Keep going.
We can't. We're going to be here because we did 50 questions. Yeah.
Okay.
They love you.
Oh, really?
Half of them.
Well, there's one good news story.
What?
Nikki, you can take solace in the fact that you beat out Adrian.
You did.
Yeah.
Oh, huge.
But I think 1%.
No. No. Dude, people love you.
Yeah.
People
really?
Love you. Yeah, we just got the research back.
Oh, good.
But you know who, out of the 50 questions, number 4 was?
Not me. Okay, Edgefiles, listener email, open phones. Open phones?
Drum roll, please.
No?
Come on. I'm
open
pointing
phones.
At you.
Me? I'm scared to say anything.
Yeah, no, it wasn't you either.
Oh, okay. I knew. I said listener email. I said listener email.
Number eight.
Out of 50, you're right in the middle. People loved you.
Oh, good.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
You know.
And as I said to the people that did the research, suck it. I love her. She's scum. She's staying.
Really?
Yeah.
Lights up the phones like you do.
Nobody. Look,
that's true. No one.
Yeah. If this is any indication, every time you're here, our phones from the second you get here to the second you leave are rammed. And if it's also any indication, the hardest I laugh is when you come here.
Oh, thank you, Dean.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thanks.
And who was the first again?
Edgefiles.
Oh, Edgefiles. They're fine.
People like them.
The Edgefiles.
I think I'm going to stop doing them.
Oh, really? You don't like it?
No.
Why?
No, I didn't do it anymore.
Too much work?
Yeah. You know how hard it is to cut and paste these days?
Yeah, I know. Make that easier, eh?
Let's get to some predictions.
Oh, yes. Now, there's going to be a major breakthrough in the cure for baldness.
No, there's not.
Yeah, 24.
Yeah, okay, that's good for you,
buddy. Now, it's going to be a 24-hour pill.
She doesn't know.
Listen to this.
I got lots of hair.
Listen to this.
It's on my back.
I dreamt of a bald head. Okay. I dreamt of a bald head.
Were you looking down at it?
Yeah. A few nights.
What was it? Bibbidi-bobbid?
You know, like Howie Mandel's head?
I dreamt of a bald head. Yeah. I was looking down, and the man was talking like this.
Yeah, and it was a few nights ago, and I dreamt that it grew hair within 24 months. I mean, within 24 hours.
Really?
Right. From taking a pill. So bald people out there, there's hope. 24-hour
Or you
pill?
People with the really bad toupees.
Oh, I was in the mall. Oh, yeah. I know it sounds stupid that I was in a mall, but I was in a mall the other day. And I walked through the food court to go get a smoothie, one of them shakes or whatever, mm-hmm. the protein jumps. God, it sucked because I walked right by Man Chew Walk and I wanted that so bad.
Oh, isn't that good? All the different combos.
Yeah, teriyaki experience.
Oh, yeah.
That's
good, too.
Really?
Yeah, really. I was walking in the mall. Seriously. So I walked. This guy had the worst comb over. Listen, if you have... shut the music off. Listen to me. If you have a toupee or if you have a wig, and I don't want to get emails from people going, well, what about my aunt? She's got a wig and she's got cancer. That's terrible. No, I'm not talking about that. If you are losing your hair to male pattern baldness, we know. We know when you wear a toupee or you have a comb over. You're not fooling us. That hair you get from the back and bring to the front... It looks like a barcode. You look ridiculous. Stop doing it. Or wearing a toupee. There's two different tones and styles and combs of hair. You look stupid. I know a guy that attached a Bluetooth to his toupee.
Oh, yeah? You can get accessories for the toupee now?
Yeah. Swiss Army toupee.
Well, you won't have to do that anymore.
Well, I guess not. So that's good news.
You just pop a pill and you grow hair fast. Right. Yeah, that's the new thing.
Just on the head or it would be terrible if your face grew it?
Oh, yeah. How do they know for it to go? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, there's a possibility that you could grow hair on your face and your nose and everywhere. Mm-hmm. Not good.
Chia.
You can also, I hear, pop a pill and you can grow a boner.
Did you know that? Did you predict Viagra?
I did.
Well, or was that another
one? That's just because her boyfriends needed it.
Yeah. That's like the
all you mean you hoped for Viagra. Yeah.
That's for sure.
You know an Oscar.
But something in, this is one of my other predictions today, something in pineapple, because you've got to eat pineapple, is going to really help your sex drive.
Well, apparently pineapple is really good. It makes your stuff taste sweet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It definitely does. I can confirm.
Really?
Yep. Todd told me once.
Really, Todd? What happened?
He's like, Dean, you must have been eating pineapple.
That's very, very sweet.
Yeah. What?
It was unbelievable.
Really?
And it's like a life colada.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
He called it a Dina colada.
A Dina colada?
Yeah. You want some?
Oh, I like that.
Yep.
Pina coladas are good. But I drink virgin pina coladas because I don't drink.
I don't know.
No one cares.
Now, scientists... okay. Scientists are actually going to bring dead bodies alive in the future. Right. So if you die, you can come back.
Wow.
Yeah, isn't that wild?
You know, you can make predictions. How far down the road? Like 50, 100 years?
Well, no, this could be in the next 10 years.
In the next 10 years, they're going to bring people back to life?
Yeah. Like, now, they're doing it.
Imagine them bringing you back to life and you were just so happy to be done with it.
I know. No.
Or you committed suicide or something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
My head looks weird.
Okay. Oh, man.
No, but what they're going to do
this is going to look stupid.
No, you know what?
It's like someone took a bite out of it.
Should have just took pills.
They're going to inject the bodies with a serum. They're going to inject the bodies with serum that makes you young.
Or if you died in some gay prison sex orgy.
Yeah. Oh, God. Ow! This is really painful. No. Oh, now I remember it, too.
I can't you kill the memories?
No, they're going to kill the memory. You're right, Derek. Kill the memory. They will. But isn't that great? Now,
yeah, so the world's population can...
Yeah, now Larry King is going to get frozen. Now, they have a new method.
Hasn't he been for, like, the last few years?
Yeah. Right. But he's going to... When he dies, he's going to have a method of freezing. Now, they are going to try to bring you back if you're frozen, too. So that's another way.
Didn't Walt Disney do that?
Yeah. The funniest one's the Ted Williams one. See, if you own a cryogenic freezing company, you got to make sure you hire the right night watchman. Because the night watchman, I'm not kidding you, they were playing baseball with his head.
Yeah.
Oh, were they really? Yeah. Oh, no. That's terrible. That's terrible.
Hey, go deep.
500.
Hey, you want to play 500 with William's head? 220.
But it's ice, isn't it? An iced head?
Yeah.
It'll go further.
It might.
Oh, it did. His ear broke off. His cranium fell off. His nose fell off. It's one of the biggest travesties. And apparently his kid, too, who got his inheritance and put him in cryogenic, killed himself like not long after. Or died or something.
Yeah, and Ted didn't even want to be in the frozen.
No, he didn't even want to be. That guy didn't want to be alive either. Yeah.
Right. Now.
Right. Back to me.
Right. Now. Right. Scientists are going to invent a device that will separate conjoined twins.
Conjoined, so, actually.
Conjoined twins. Yeah, conjoined.
Saw?
Twins. Yeah.
I was thinking that too, but that just sounded vicious.
So it's going to be an easier way to separate the twins if they're Siamese or what have you, you know? Yeah. And I see a cat being born in China with a head on each side.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, like a head at the back.
What a coincidence. That happened yesterday in Jiangsu province, I read this morning.
Really?
Yeah.
I never saw that.
No kidding.
No, I'm sure it is.
Well. Wow. And also, I see a huge dragon.
And I think it's only happened about 4,000 times.
Has it happened a bunch?
Yeah, two-faced pigs, two-faced dogs.
But one right on the butt?
Yeah, and on the butt. A head on the butt and a head in the front.
Oh,
like a long one, like two heads.
No, I Paul. Oh, it's like a Chinese finger trap.
Exactly. Yeah, right. Don't eat that one.
What a coincidence that it was in China.
Yeah. Now, a huge dragon, because it's a year of the black dragon, is going to be...
Oh, actually, it's not. We got to correct you. Someone corrected you last week. It's a year of the dragon, so you're technically right. It's not the year of the black dragon.
It is.
Okay, well, then it is.
Yeah, in China, it's a year of the black dragon.
Should we look that up just to be sure?
Yeah. Because the last thing we need is some crazy person coming down here going,
get that right.
Yeah, or the last thing we need is false information going over the air when Nikki's on.
Yeah.
It's a black dragon. I'm telling you, I talked to my Asian friends. They already explained.
You have those?
Come on.
Korean and Asian.
Oh, you're lucky.
Korean and Asian.
Yeah.
It's 2012 is a black dragon.
Yes.
Water dragon. Or Blackwater Dragon.
There you go.
Or just Year of the Dragon. Or just Year of the Dragon.
Okay, now a huge dragon is going to be found, a real dragon.
With fire?
In a mountain in China. And he's going to start an eruption there. Like, I'm definitely seeing a dragon.
Weird.
No, it's not weird. This is 2000.
You're weird.
No, Derek, this is 2012, okay?
Yeah, it's okay to be weird.
I told you that there's going to be weird things happening in the world.
Derek.
It hasn't happened yet.
Stupid.
Sorry, dragon. Yeah.
You know, it's 9:21
Friday.
Brady!
Brady!
Every Friday she's here. Psychic Nikki's back. Good morning.
Good morning, Dinas. God, I throw that one in.
I love it. A couple more predictions, then we'll get some phone calls in a few minutes. What do you got?
Okay, now Vice President Joe Biden has to watch his health a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay, now I see a UFO sightings over Manhattan and Toronto and Washington.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
awesome,
gonna be like Independence Day. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm out of here.
Yeah. You're out of
there. Out of here.
Yeah. And I do see. I see a clown running for politics, like a clown from the circus.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
like with his nose and stuff
right.
on, or
yeah, he's
oh
gonna,
really?
And he's gonna win somewhere.
That happened in Brazil.
It did.
Yeah. A some clown like ran for Senate or something like that, and he won, and then they wouldn't let him in unless he changed.
Oh, really?
And
really?
He's like in you know Brazilian. I'm not changing for nobody.
What about the what about the clown right here in the city trying to lose weight?
Oh yeah, we got an ass clown for a mayor.
Wouldn't it be great to have a clown for a mayor?
We have one.
Oh no, I mean with a clown face and everything.
No, we have one.
His face is red.
Oh okay.
He's got a red nose, but I'm not sure what that's from.
Now there's going to be.
Oh, I know it's from.
What's that?
Oh, I don't.
Standing up.
Yeah.
Well, I did say he would lose weight.
Yeah.
Now, there's going to be a pill to for a cure for women's muffin tops and also men's beer bellies. You know how a woman has a muffin top?
Explain.
Well, you know, like that flab around the stomach.
Show us.
Yeah.
No, I don't have a muffin. Show me your muffin.
Yeah, I got a huge one.
Oh, okay.
Actually, no, I don't. I'm pretty good, though.
I have dust on my muffin. Oh, wow. No, I'm
really?
Only kidding. No,
it's
no.
all about the product. Eh?
No, pill for muffin tops. Now, a lot of women have that. It's called spread, or middle-aged spread.
Ew.
Or muffin. A muffin top.
I've never heard it described.
As, you know what? I'm interested in Nikki's expertise in the muffin top arena.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so, you know, like, you get this fat around your stomach.
Yes.
Going down from, like, your, I guess, the waist. A lot of women suffer from that. So now they're going to have a pill that you just pop, and it goes away within a month.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, that's good.
They had that a while ago. It was called Fenfen. Did you hear about that?
Fenfen?
Yeah, it was like killing people all over the place. They had this weight loss drug where you could actually take it. But basically all you did was crap out all your food, everything. You just crap. You kept pooping. And my friend's ex-wife was taking it. She was having these crazy like heart palpitations in the middle of the night, but she lost a bunch of weight. And like then she had a heart attack, and she's like, it was so worth it.
Oh, really?
Look at me.
Wow.
Yeah, beautiful.
I remember saying to her, dude, you got to stop doing this to yourself. And she's like, no, it's fine. I just go.
Well, you know, it's just like Demi Moore. She's worried about getting old and fat, and she looks great.
No,
she's
you know her?
She does
you know
not.
Her?
She looks
not. No, no.
Like an orange on a toothpick.
She looks like a skeleton in junior high.
Yeah, she does. She's getting too anorexic. And you know what? Women have a lot of pressure on them because they have to
look. We don't need your political call or your commentary on. Yeah.
All right. But I'm just saying that in the future, they just have to take a pill and you will be beautiful. Hmm. Now, also, New Orleans is going to get sucked in
it's
by
sinking.
A giant sinkhole.
Hmm.
New
scary.
Orleans. Yeah,
well,
it's scary.
You know why? Because they've sucked all this I know. I don't know why I know this. Folks, listen, and you'll learn something here. They've sucked all the oil from out underneath New Orleans, so it's actually lower than sea level. And it's been getting lower and lower for every year.
Right.
So, boom, it's going to be toast.
Boom,
well, where are the Saints going to play?
Where'd they play last time?
Oh, LSU.
Who cares?
Yeah.
There's going to be flying motorcycles.
Well, that'll be cool.
No, that'll be really
flying
good.
Motorcycles.
Voluntary
flying
ones?
Motorcycles.
Oh, there is a cure for muffin tops. I just.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's called exercise.
Oh, okay. Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what Alex just sent me. I didn't know.
Oh, must okay. Now, there is flying motorcycles, flying cars. There's going to be an explosion and terrorist attack at Charing Cross in London, England, and Knightsbridge, which isn't very good. A talking monkey that talks like a human will be found in India. So a talking monkey. What?
Really?
Yeah, really.
Cool. That is a very cool monkey.
Yes. A monkey that talks. A talking monkey.
It would be so weird.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, it would be
weird.
It'd
work in a convenience store.
Now, a giant piranha fish, too.
It'd be like, any monkey can work here. He's like, I am a monkey.
Eat my damn.
And I eat banana.
That's our job.
Right? Oh, okay. Yeah.
Your job's yeah.
No, yeah. Now, to go on,
and I
actually.
Never would have said what you just said.
Yeah.
Okay,
so
now this
you,
gonna,
you just do the predictions.
Okay, now there's going to be a breakthrough in the cure for Parkinson's disease, too.
And wow, I do shaking see, it up a bit.
Yeah, now a chimney sweep. Chimney sweeps are going to be very hot again because of Mary Poppins being popular.
What did you say?
I don't know if that would offend anyone.
What?
What?
Well, she said there. I didn't even mean to say it like
what?
That.
What'd she say?
What?
Well, she said they're cure for Parkinson's. I said, cool, they're shaking it up a bit.
What's wrong with that?
No, I didn't think so.
When you get Parkinson's, you get the shakes.
Yeah.
Yeah, so do that again.
There's going to be a cure for Parkinson's disease.
Yeah, good.
Soon.
They're shaking it up a bit.
Well, they're going to help it, that's for sure. And there's going to be robotic male and female robots, okay? So if you get sick of your wife or your husband, you have one in the cupboard.
Where is my sex bot?
That's what it's going to be like in the future.
I want to put it in her.
You
metal
mean,
star.
You mean me? What kind of robot would you like?
Let's go.
Oh, okay.
One with soft lips.
Larry Hagman has to watch his health. That was a man in Dallas.
Dude, didn't he have like liver diseases? Like
he's had like seven of them.
Yeah,
livers.
Mahmoud, I'm a janja.
Say it again.
I don't want to be rude.
No, I know who you're talking about. You're
Mahmoud,
talking about the guy.
Mahmoud?
You're talking about the president or the prime minister of Iran.
He's going to be in an assassination.
What's his?
Attack.
Yeah. What's his name?
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, or Ahmadinejad. I don't mean to be disrespectful.
You're not. Want you to keep going till you get it right.
Mahmoud. Is that right? Mahmoud? Mahmoud. Mahmoud. Ahmadinejad.
It is a tough one.
It is a very tough one.
Ahmadinejad.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
Did you just say Ahmadinejad?
Ahmadinejad.
Mahmoud.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
No. Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
I hope he's not listening to this.
Ahmadinejad. Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
You're like,
you can't
son.
Say it fast because I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to say it fast like so you don't think about it too much?
Yeah. Mahmoud Ahmadinejad.
I would just call him Moody. Moody, if you're out there, you know, like.
Yeah, if you're out there.
No, Moody, no. Baby, if you're listening. The Dean Blundell Show.
Psychic Sticky's here. Good morning. We need to take a few phone calls. We don't have a lot of time, so we got to go through to. Okay, is that okay with you?
That is great.
That sounds great. We're going to go to the
phone.
Yeah,
we'll do it.
Hey, The Edge.
Hey, this is DJ Action Kenneth. I wanted to talk to Psychic Nikki.
Did he call himself DJ Action?
Kenneth?
Yeah, the one who predicted a lot of things. I'm also psychic, too.
Who is this? What's your name again? Say it slowly.
DJ Action Kenneth. I know you know me. I'm actually a DJ.
No, I don't know you.
Listen.
No, hold it. What do you call yourself? What's your real name? Is that on your birth certificate? DJ Action Kenneth?
Well, my name is Kenneth Pranzo, but my DJ name is DJ Action Kenneth.
How old are you?
24.
How long have you been DJ Action Kenneth?
Oh, pretty long. You gotta hear my mixing, man. It's insane. Insane.
DJ Action.
You have an email I can send you a copy
no,
of.
No, he says he is a psychic.
Are you psychic for real?
He's into psychic rants.
Yeah, I'm the one who predicted a lot of things. I have a Facebook page and a website and everything.
How old are you? You're 24, you said?
24, yeah. I wanted to give you out one or only two predictions, important ones that I see really.
Yeah, and
important.
Kenneth, you've been putting me down on Twitter.
I know.
How
have you really?
You can suck it,
DJ Action Kenneth. You can suck it. You can't talk bad about my girl.
I had to block him out.
I'm trying to work with her.
Yeah, you and your mother.
What did he say?
You and your mother.
You.
She's the greatest.
Hey, DJ, relax. DJ, stop.
Yeah.
Action.
Wait.
Kenneth.
Stop. Relax.
Yeah.
Now, psychic. Hey, Kenneth. Now, Nikki, what did he say that was rude?
Well, I've got it.
No, microphone's got to go on.
Oh, I've got some bad stuff by.
Like, what did he say?
Like a lot. Okay.
Like what?
I have to
give
look
me an example. Like what? Just an example of something he may have said that upset you.
Well, his mother hates psychics.
Well, that would mean his mother hates him.
Yeah.
Wow.
Something. And you said a bunch of other stuff, but I got to look it up.
Like
I think,
what?
I think I kind of like
it. It was around September. I have to look it up, Dean.
I
put it on here.
Hey, DJ, what did I say?
I
said be quiet.
Bye.
I had to block him off my site, actually.
So, DJ, were you being rude?
I guess I was.
Why?
Yes, you were.
Why are you being rude? You don't even know the woman.
It's kind of big what you just said there.
What's kind of big?
September. You know what September
is? It's a James Randi thing.
You know what September 3rd is?
Yeah, it's the third day of the first of the ninth month of the year.
September 3rd, 2012 is a New York City earthquake, a 7.3 earthquake. There's a 7.3 earthquake coming that day.
Yeah, there is for sure?
Yes.
How do you know?
Oh, I'm sure.
What do you see?
At 6 a.m., 6 p.m., 12 a.m., 12 p.m.
I like this guy, though.
I
he
do
says
too.
Things with conviction. I will say that.
Yeah. Passion.
So there's going to be an earthquake at
7.3 magnitude earthquake.
That's pretty big, eh? What was the one in Japan?
The one in Japan was 7.2.
7.7.
Are we going to feel it up here, all the way up here?
Nikki, oh, yeah.
Nikki, do you see this? Do you see this, too?
I see it, too.
Well, why don't you guys get to be friends and do this stuff?
I don't want
to
be his friend. He was rude. He was terribly rude.
Well, why don't you say sorry, Kenneth?
I got all my posts directed to any people. I don't direct it to any people to hurt anybody. I just post what I can.
No, I had to block you out. All right. Really
all right.
Yeah, Kenneth, do you have a sausage in your mouth right now?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let me just ask you.
The answer is yes. Kenneth does have a sausage in his mouth.
Sounds like it.
Can I ask you a question?
Yep.
Do you see me getting off medication in the future?
Do I see you what?
Getting off medication in the future.
What are you on medication for?
Oh, just a stroke.
A stroke?
You had a stroke?
Yeah.
How old were you?
16.
Dude, this guy is psychic.
I think he's lying. You had a stroke.
He thinks he's lying.
What kind of stroke? Nikki, oh, really? What kind
I
of stroke?
I had a stroke in the caudate of my brain.
What kind of medication are you on?
I'm on aspirin and medicine for the stroke. I don't know exactly what the ones are. I don't know.
Oh.
I thought you just had a Boston accent.
He's from Nova Scotia.
I could give you another prediction about something with the money, involving money.
Yeah, go ahead.
The February 2nd, 2 a.m., 2 p.m. stock market crash.
February 2nd?
February 2nd or February 16th.
Oh, well,
it's a third.
One down.
So, no.
And May 2nd and May 16th.
Of 2012? February's gone, so May.
Yeah.
What other day? You want to pick every other day of the year?
I could give one for you today.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is it?
February 3rd, 3 a.m., 3 p.m.
What is it?
It involves technology, computers, and cars, and driving, and it involves your radio station itself, the job, the technology of it.
What about
that's
it?
Today. Like a computer crash or something?
Maybe, I think, yeah. I see a computer crashing.
Oh, today?
Well, that that happens almost every day.
So, DJ Action Kenneth, I'm going to put you on hold, okay?
All right.
And then, because I want to get your information.
All right,
hang on. I wonder how many people like DJ Action Kenneth exist. What, don't do that. Don't wave him off because people wave you off, and I have you on for the last 6 years.
Right.
Okay, so don't do that to Kenneth.
I'll show you everything.
Well, I know you'll show me your text. He was sending text to. See, when people tweet and you get them, it doesn't mean that they're sending it to you. You're following them, or oh no, he's giving it to you.
He mentioned.
So you think he's full of crap?
He was reported already.
He was reported
by who?
Yeah. By
what?
A lot of people.
Oh, really?
Reported.
Yeah.
DJ Action Kenneth.
Yeah.
I've been getting some mean guy to me on Twitter.
I don't get any.
Really?
No. Can I ask you something? How accurate were his...
I didn't even
feel?
Listen.
You didn't?
Nope.
Oh, that's not fair.
Listen. He
may be accurate.
7.3 magnitude earthquake in New York.
Right.
September 3rd.
September the 3rd, he said.
Right.
Right?
I didn't get the time.
Do you see that?
I said I saw a large one in New York, yeah.
Around there?
Absolutely.
Okay, so why don't you guys put the gloves down and be friends?
No.
Why? Sounds like you want to sleep with each other and have psychic children.
Please.
That's what it sounds like. You're very psychic children.
Please. How can he be? Look,
please.
Honestly,
you think she still have kids?
I know. She's just trying to. You know, like when like these quick lover spats and they say they hate each other.
Yeah,
like, you two, just. Dude, except why? You don't like a challenge. You should like a challenge.
No, I don't mind the challenge from people like, you know.
No, you don't like the challenge. You're scared of the challenge.
You back down too easy.
No,
you do.
I've got to show you stuff on here.
But who cares? Laugh it off.
All right, I'll laugh it off.
Be confident.
Right.
If I got sour every time someone said they hated me or the show sucked, all of us, we would never do this
show. Okay, Ken, so I love you.
No.
No, not like that.
But Does if he was rude to you, I'm going as you. I let you talk, and I.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, you're my hero. I love you.
Thank you.
Don't back down so easy.
Don't back down.
You know how many women have said, oh, you're a douche, I'm not going to end the next thing you know? It's like, whoa, that was great.
Yeah.
He was reported by a lot of people.
To the police or
to Twitter? To Twitter. Well, oh.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.